So we arrived here to Sandy River, Oregon. This place was shut down since 2015. They open up for today, only one day a year, and it's not even a full day. It's gonna be open from noon till 7. So let's go get that smell. Look how big is this smelt. It's about 6 inches or more. It's a really good size smelt. It looked like it's a male, slim belly. Usually female, got a full belly of eggs. So you can see this is a male. It's not so many of them, so we got little bits. It's kind of slow right now. We hope it's gonna pick up a little bit. It's so much fun to be out. Look at all of these people. All of them came here to Dipnet some of this smelt. One by one, and this bucket's gonna be full. So to fill this bucket, it's about gonna be 40 pounds. And it's only 10 pounds per angler. So we don't want that water, because water, doesn't matter how much it is, it's gonna add the weight. Let's wash them. Let's wash them because they're gonna be in the sand. Some kind of a secret. You gotta let share it.
Let's see. 25.
25 pounds here, okay?
Yeah.
That's good to know.
Sure. good dip. That's better. Oh, yeah, that's better.
Eight of us, you got
8 pounds.
This is 30 to 30. Yeah, just one of buckets. That's under 10 pounds. Yeah, we got 2 more buckets, that's under 10 pounds. And 8 of us.
8 of you, alright. What time did you guys start?
Oh, we start maybe like 12.
Okay, 12.
Look at this smelt right here. We got here about 80 pounds, 8 of us was here. Our smelt fishing just came to the end. Me and my family, we came out here to Sandy River, Oregon. We had so much fun. Me and my kids, our whole family, 8 of us, we got 80 pounds of smelt. So see you guys at home at our kitchen. Welcome to our kitchen. So we are back from smelt fishing. I took out my kids, my family, we had so much fun, weather was good, it was unbelievable. Now we're gonna prepare a really nice meal, so let's go. With our smelt, I wanna make really tasty dipping sauce. 1/4 cup of onion, 1 stick of celery. And let's blend this up a little bit. Just like that. And let's transfer this to small bowl. I will add whole tomato and make tomato puree. I'll add 2 tablespoons of tomato paste. Add some olive oil to our pot. How about that much right there? We're gonna add some butter. We'll add our 2 cloves of garlic, diced up. We'll add celery and onion. A 1/4 teaspoon of oregano. I'll add a little bit of a black pepper. Add black pepper to your liking, so I'll put about this much. Cayenne pepper, just a little bit. Right there. And I'll add some kosher salt. Add salt and black pepper to your likings. Look at this golden color. This is how we want. And now I'm gonna add our tomato puree. Okay. This sauce is gonna take a little bit of a time to finish up cooking, so we're gonna move this to our main stove and we're gonna start preparing our fish. Today we're gonna try two different methods. First method, we're gonna clean the fish, remove the heads and the guts. And the second method, we're gonna leave the fish as a whole the way it is, just clean it really good. And we're gonna use cast iron skillet to pan fry them. From the top of the fish, we're gonna cut through the carcass like that, turn the fish around. And from the vet up, we're gonna open up the belly and cut the sides. And pull everything out. Everything came out just like that. Our fish is ready to be pan fried. We have seasoned up flour. I add a little bit of salt, black pepper and paprika. And also we have egg wash here, 2 eggs and 2 tablespoons of water to water down a little bit. And we have breadcrumbs. I'm gonna dunk it in the flour first. Then egg wash. Then breadcrumbs. I will add avocado oil about 1 inch to my cast iron skillet. And you can add any kind of oil that's in high flash point. I'll make sure our temperature gets to 350 degrees. I'll check it with the thermometer. Our oil reached 350 degrees, so it's time to put the fish in. We're gonna pan fry it 2 minutes per side. It's time to take them out. Yeah, look at this beautiful color. Yeah, this looks really good. Very tasty. Time to pan fry whole fish. Ah, what a gorgeous color. Look at this beautiful color. That looks good. It's not only looks good, it smells so good. I wish you would be here to smell the smell. Oh man, so aromatic smell. Okay, it's ready to come out. Good to go. This is the final product. It's time to try it. Wow. It's so soft and gentle meat. I'm gonna pull out the carcass. Look at this soft and gentle meat. This is looks really good. I'm gonna break off this piece right here and dip it in a sauce. Oh, look at that. Ah. Tell me this doesn't look good. This is so good. Mm. Let's try the one that we didn't do anything, but rinsed and cleaned it really good. So let's see what is the difference. I'm gonna break off the head, just like that, pull out the carcass, and let's open up and see. All right, I don't see much of a difference. This is the meat. Yeah, I pulled out the carcass. The barely any gut, just a little bit. Let's try it. This is so good. This is really tasty. To me, clean fish, cut off heads and neck, pull the guts out, there is barely any guts. And the one that we didn't do anything tastes exactly the same. So the only difference, you're gonna save time by just washing it and pan fry it. Cleaning takes a little bit longer. So that's your own preference. If you want to save a little bit of a time, pan fry them as a whole. This is so good. The sauce and the fish combination, they go so well together. Very, very tasty. I love it. Overall, smelt is really good and very tasty fish. It is really safe for children. All you do is just peel fillets off, pull out the carcass, and it's good to eat. So this is it, guys. That's all we got for you for today. So please, thumbs up, subscribe, and leave the comments below. See you guys on the next video.